dude, let's talk about TNA. And they just call you up and say, hey, man, here's what we're going to offer you. I'm not asking for numbers, but how did they structure their offer with you?
Well, I was wrestling World Wrestling All-Stars, I believe it was. They were doing this tour, and I went down there and wrestled and met Jeff Jarrett. Mm-hmm. And he was the one, him and his father were running TNA. Basically struck a deal there in Australia. Didn't think much of it. You know, I thought it's another independent. I'll go do it, make some money while I'm at it. That's how, as far as I know, I was the first guy they ever signed to a deal. So
what were your thoughts on TNA? I mean, because you spent, 12 years there?
11 years, 11 strong years there. And listen, for 6 months, I didn't care. To me, it was another independent. And I was okay with that because it was a Wednesday night and I didn't have anything going on anyway. I was able to earn some bucks. As it grew, as people told me that this place is going to go out of business and it never did, and you go, you know what? We got something here. And I was having unbelievable matches with Low Key and Jerry Lynn. Jerry Lynn, one of my favorites, one of the guys I learned a lot from. And then went on to started doing more stuff and gets bought out by Panda Energy. And then this thing's really starting to go. Now we start moving to Orlando. I mean, it was a slow build, and now it's really taking a turn for something big here.
Why leave TNA?
I feel like when you work hard, you should get paid for that.
Damn right.
And I worked hard. I never, got in trouble. I never did anything to embarrass the company, and yet I was taking a pay cut. At least that's what they wanted me to. I didn't think that was right. I put a bet on myself. I bet myself that I could go to Ring of Honor and then somehow get in the New Japan. And everything worked out, and that bet worked. I believe in myself.